Testing. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakumullahu khair, Mufti and Dr. Muhammad Salah, for the fantastic lectures you have given us today. My question is, your talks today mentioned about the love of the Prophet and to follow his teachings, his sunnah, and being genuine as well. My question is, recently we have read a lot of reports about increasing religiosity within the Southeast Asian region and in Singapore. And with more people attending more religious classes, how can we protect ourselves to ensure that the knowledge we receive is that of the genuine knowledge which the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught to us, and not a twisted version which we know that a lot of it has been going around today? So essentially, how do we protect ourselves from certain radicalization ideologies? Thank you.
I think the first question that was asked by the brother, yes, it is very encouraging to notice that there is a lot happening in terms of Islamic teachings and so on. Primarily, we need to be able to distinguish between that which is revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that which is in the authentic narrations of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that which was done by the earliest of generations, the generations of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and those that followed immediately after. What we need to do is we will need to go deeper than just listen to one talk. Generally, there is no debate about certain items. If someone tells you, look, there are five salah in the day, you need to read your Quran, you need to do your dhikr, you need to engage in, for example, you need to fast in Ramadan, you need to do Hajj if you can and if you are able. There are no debates generally when it comes to these items. They are known. But when people start going beyond that, you can ask yourself more questions and you can clarify and clear and continue asking until you are satisfied that this response is coming from an authentic source. When we say authentic source, it is referring to the Quran, the Sunnah of Rasulullah ﷺ, and the understanding of the earliest of generations. So if it is something that came later on, you would be able to figure as you continue to ask that this is actually added on later. And today what I've noticed is there is a lot that is said online. So if you are to know certain platforms that are legit, people who only respond to you from that which is authentic, you can quickly clarify to say, look, you know what, we've learned this. Is it authentic? And I have a policy. Sometimes with the young people, they ask you and it's not easy to answer them in one line. So I tell them, look, if something is heavily debated, leave it out. The chances of you doing that which is right will be more. Because if something is debated and you engage in it, the chances of you doing something wrong are great. Say, for example, even if it comes to halal and haram, if I were to tell you that this here is alcoholic, and someone tells you, no, it's not. So there are one of two options. Either I drink it or I don't drink it. If I drink it, there is a chance. Some people are saying you will be drinking something wrong. And some are saying you will be drinking right. There is a chance I'm right, a chance I'm wrong. But if I don't drink it, there is no chance I'm wrong. No chance at all. So this